Hi, in this video we will take a look at one very interesting book related to basic programming language. I don't usually do any kind of book reviews on my channel, but this is kind of exception. So this is the book in question. It's called Four Basic to One-Liners and it was written by Holger Wessling. As the name suggests, it's all about writing one-liner code in BASIC, but not only on Commodore platform, but also on Atari and some other platforms as well. So yeah, let's take a look inside. And here we are. Now, before we start to exploring this lovely book, a little spoiler at the beginning. Of course, it's all about one-liners in basic programming language, but also this book is very good for anyone who wants to program in basic programming language. The way how it's written, it's absolutely beautiful. This book is almost like a little encyclopedia of all these tips and tricks and peaks and pokes and every little thing that you can imagine just in one single book, which is absolutely amazing. So yeah, let's begin. And you will see this immediately when I open this contents page. There is so many chapters and there is so many things covered in this book that is almost unbelievable. Look at this. And there is more, of course. So many things. Yeah, it's, I don't know how much you can see, but this is absolutely amazing. Of course, for introduction, we have all of these different people who were involved in developing basic programming language one way or another. And the way how it's written or printed, I mean, it's really easy to follow. Each of these paragraphs is labeled, the topic is here, so you can see immediately what this part of the text is talking about, and we have lovely graphics as well. I mean, this is absolutely beautiful. And now here we begin. Of course, this is actual beginning with programming, and it's called Basic Basics. And you can see here it's all about mathematical priorities, of course, explaining which of these operations are executed first. And we have rounding variables, system variables like TI for time, ST for status, and some constants. And you can see here we have pi and some other trigonometric constants, true false operators, and of course peek and poke commands as well. Of course, we have go to and go sub commands also. And of course, we have the whole chapter explaining how these programs are stored in the memory on Commodore 64. Really nicely explained. Of course, free memory detection code here. Also, here are some of the examples. Additional memory requirements for variables and really detailed stuff you can see here. Of course, then we have file formats for Commodore 64. And then we have explanation for basic abbreviations and tokens, for basic C basic variant, Simons basic, tuned Simons basic, and Vision basic as well. There is also other basic versions mentioned here. Of course, we have a section to explain time measuring. So this is important because the most of the code written or mentioned in this book does have some kind of benchmark or some other measurement related to it. So for example, this piece of code We have measurement that it contains only 74 characters, right? And in some examples, we also have number of characters or number of GIFs. Sometimes it's size, sometimes it's speed, depending on the code itself. And there is some lovely graphics here. And this is one of the examples that I really like. It's really challenging to create one-liner, to create this blue cross. You can track how that little piece of code, and it starts with 77 characters, and then it speaks about how to make it shorter. And now we have a length of 71 characters, then 67, 66, 63, 61, 60. So all different methods and tips how to make your code shorter. And this is a great way to learn how you can make your code shorter. So, well, effectively you're writing a one-liner code. And then we go to 52 characters and 52 again. And this is, I believe, the end. So finally we started with 77 characters here, and now we are end up with 52 characters doing exactly the same thing. So in this example, I think that's the great way to see how to make your program shorter, how that actually works. Yeah, and here is the section for quotation marks for print command. Each previous content must be closed. The closing quotation mark can be omitted if the print is placed at the end of the line. So, for example, here's how you can save one character in case that you need to print something. If this is the last thing that you're going to do in this line, you can omit the last quotation. You don't need to close the text in the quotation marks for defining variables as string variables as well. That's really nice. And then there is lovely comparison. Is it faster to use SQR or square command? It takes 8 characters. We can achieve the same thing using the potential of 0.5 of 1/2, that's 60 characters, but this is this one is faster, this one is slower, but it does save 2 characters, which is very, very interesting. Of course, pi as a counter, very nice. And then we have a random function in different way, all sorts of explanation about that. I mean, it covers almost everything. Additional tips and tricks how to clear the screen in 2 ways. Screen colors, screen again. The way how to set up cursor to the upper left corner, cursor position anywhere you want. Yeah, this is a good example here. So this is using the sys command, this is without sys command. Yeah, very interesting. Without line break. Yeah, all of different examples is covered here. I mean, this is absolutely great work. These are good examples here. So toggle between 1 and 0, or minus 1 and 0, and minus 1 and 1. You know, sometimes you need that to create some logic, and this is very useful. And here we have the whole section of the book dedicated to the speed as well. Well, there is so many things that can affect the speed of your code, and believe me, some things are really not so easy, not so logical, but they are. Of course, we have lots of examples which is faster or not. And of course, we have zero or dot here covered. Of course, you can see that using dot instead of zero is way faster. Of course, single character variables versus two characters for naming your variables, that kind of makes sense. But there is one example that I didn't know, which is absolutely ludicrous, but let me find it. Okay, optimized multiplication. Sorry, I missed it at first. So, for instance, if you want to multiply two numbers, it's always faster to use the bigger number first, then multiply it with smaller number, smaller in number of characters needed to define that number, then vice versa. I mean, it's mind-blowing. And of course, there is a section of things to avoid, probably the things that creates the false results and stuff like that. And then we have finally, after almost more than half of the book, we have one-liners, a section that speaks about one-liners. And this is important because, you know, there is so many little things that you need to know before you start writing one-liner code. And yeah, and this book covers all of them, which is beautiful. Okay, so about one-liners, there is some rules here. There is sources for the 10-liner competitions, and we have 20-liner competitions, and yeah, some other examples. This is Mandelbrot example. Here are some very famous examples of one-liners, like 10 print maze, and we have 10 print maze in color, which is very nice. And we have high resolution 10 print maze, which is interesting. And there is one historical side note, which is very fun. And it says that one of the first ever one-liner was actually written for Commodore PET, and it was published in the PET Gazette magazine from 1978, which is interesting. Yeah. And we have one liner on Commodore 64 that lists all commands. Yeah, here we go. So, well, Commodore 64 doesn't have like help or list all commands that are available. And we have a small one-line code that can do just that. This is absolutely fantastic. And this is one name that you should recognize, or maybe you don't, but I certainly do. Well, it's Ian Whitnam example of his lovely maze, 10 print maze. It's just absolutely beautiful. Oh, and there is one part that mentioned actually one also famous channel as well. Well, and there is so many examples. Eagle, colorful patterns. This is laser, C64. Bird can fly, one-liner. Of course, this is the laser. Also from Back to Basic. Yeah. And we have Sid. And we have Signful, one-liner to produce sign. And we have Ian Whitman again, with his lovely 10 print maze with shading and stuff. I mean, this guy is absolutely amazing. And then we have some basic demos and all sorts of sources related to one-liners or 10-liners. There was some competition about 10 print maze, to print them vertical, diagonal, and we have triangles and stuff like that. And I won the first one, which was the vertical. Yeah, this is my code here. Yeah, so yeah, lots of interesting things and some curiosities about calculate with peak. Wow, that's interesting. TI as counter, and how to use on error go to. Oh wow, that's nice. Randomized text. Fun with TI string. I should try that. Okay, and now this is my favorite part. I mean, this table is absolutely amazing. These are all peaks and pokes and sys and weights and characters. I mean, everything that you can imagine, it's here. Very nicely explained and labeled. I mean, this, look at this. Peaks and pokes. All of these pokes, system calls. I mean, they're all here. Wait, and of course, special characters for the color or other special functions. Of course, there is some links on the web that you can check out here, and all the sources that was used. Of course, we cannot be without screen codes of the Commodore 64 and PESCII code chart, of course, as well. And then we have basic dialects. This is table of commands in comparison on all different platforms. So yeah, you can compare the same commands, how they're named in different platforms, which is amazing, actually. Yeah, and this is the end. I mean, I highly recommend this book to anyone that's into basic programming. But, you know, even you are not in one-liners, I mean, this book is absolutely fantastic. Yeah, this was all for me, and until next time, goodbye.